so look out. We are live outside at Empire Fight Camp. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Nice to be here with you.
And now it's time for the tale of the tape. And here is Nigel Benn. He's 5 foot 10 inches tall with a 72.8 inch reach. Many argue this man is the greatest super middleweight of all time, Carl the Cobra Frotch. 6 foot 1 inches tall with a 75.2 inch reach.
There is no joke about this. Someone is going to get hurt. The other is going to get embarrassed.
It's Nigel. Carl the Cobra Frotch, one of the greatest super middleweight champions of all time, fighting out of Nottingham, United Kingdom.
This bout is scheduled for 8 rounds of boxing. Fighting out of the red corner from London, England, here is a middleweight and super middleweight champion of the world, known as the Dark Destroyer, introducing Nigel Benn. Fighting out of the blue corner, introducing from Nottingham, England, a super middleweight champion of the world, Carl the Cobra Frotch.
You've heard of people dancing underneath the moonlight. Tonight, it's a fight underneath the moonlight. And what a fight it should be.
It's cooled down a little bit.
And there's the bell to start the round. When are we going to see a jab from these two? You don't want to trade shots. A rowdy crowd awaits our main event tonight. They've had all day to pregame. The media's ready, the fans are ready, and you know the fighters are ready.
These fighters are about to block themselves off and say, right, that's it. Keep out of it. Now it's fight time. The whole day, everybody's been waiting for these two. This is it. This is it.
There's a counter shot. You don't want to go tit for tat in there in this fight. These two are the perfect dance partners.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. Just like a match made in heaven.
Both men step back for just a moment. This is the type of fighter that would say, I don't even want rounds. Let's just fight until one of us can't stand up anymore.
Oh, this is a struggle right here in front of me. These kind of fighters, they want to get hit in the face.
The Dark Destroyer now in a very dark place.
Does he know he's hurt him? Look at him. That back foot, Brett, it completely shivered. Did you see that, Tom?
And it appears the onslaught is over, at least for now.
What recovery skills they are. What a shot it was. Completely gone, I thought.
Very close round with 10 seconds to go. Let's talk about Ben in that last round. He is down big time on the scores.
Needs a knockout without a doubt. Needs to go out there and think, right, you know what? Next round, you're getting it. You're going to get it. Kitchen sink.
What are you doing? Come on, you're switching off. You've got complete.
Stop and don't give him anything. Go back and win the round, right?
Yeah. Come on, you're letting back into this. You're better than this, kid. Go back.
That's a tougher fight. He's got to be confident. You've got to take that confidence away. Go out in the first minute, stick him on the end of a jab, and then start gathering your pace and win this round back. Take away that.
Be smart when you go out there. Just take the round off. Win the round at shot.
Get this boxing back together.
I need you to switch back on. Get focused.
We're hoping for an all-action slugfest. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight. You're fine. Hold him. Tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if he doesn't, he's going to pop you off.
Jab misses. Cobra is down.
Is he out? Is he going to move? Is there a twitch?
Halfway through the round, and they've got some work to do to get back into it. The referee says we will fight on. Not sure about this one.
That is a show of character. When you're put down, your ego's hurt, your chin's hurt, your body's hurting, and you've got to get up.
Nigel Benn has been rocked.
Oh, what a shot. He's staggered. He's staggered.
He's back up, but is he just delaying the inevitable?
Well, now it's about getting back to the corner, freshen up, getting new instructions given to you, and they've got to G you up.
You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Both men getting off the canvas in that incredible round.
Sometimes you talk about drawing first blood. What does that tell you?
Okay, now you're switching off. You're starting to make mistakes. You're switching off.
You jab and breathe when you're stepping around.
Back into it. Now it's a tougher fight, and he's going to be confident. You've got to take that.
Get back out there and win the round. You've got complacent. The fight's not over yet. You've got to go out there and win this round. You had everything in the bag, and now you've...
Don't worry about that round. Let's go out there. Let's reset.
You're much better than this guy. You're much better. He's not in your league.
Go out there and win this next round. Get out there and
swing him in this round. Don't worry about that round. Don't.
Look on the job. That's a terrible round, that is. Come on.
And that'll do it for the time between rounds as we get set to get back in the action.
Come on, switch on. Get your boxing back together. Put him back on in this round.
Not a lot of punch output. Thought there might be more action here. Don't get caught up on how many times this guy gets hit. He's a slugger, Johnny. And you know, he's just waiting for his opportunity to strike back.
Speed generates power. Timing is everything. If you've got speed, you can pop, knock anybody out. You just got to hit him in the right spot.
Well done with that counter shot. Jab misses. Big hook thrown, but it doesn't connect. Swinging big and missing big with that hook. Can they figure out the combination to this sink?
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight would say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them, more than happy.
When you've got two evenly matched fighters in this weight class, it sometimes comes down to who's in better condition. Time they throw a shot, they get countered. Swing and a miss with the hook. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Nice counter shot. Let's talk about Ben in that last round. You know that bell was sweet music to his ears.
The bell, sometimes it can be the sweetest sound.
Keep looking at him. He's absolutely knackered, mate. He's knackered.
Just keep breath. Bang him downstairs. Jab him downstairs. Stop it.
Confidence is going to be stretching out his gas tank now. Keep whacking into the body.
It's important now in this first minute, this next round, that you get on top of him. Keep him busy with the jab, working behind the jab, and then let his shots go. Don't let him get back in at this fight. Come on, you
to this fight. It's so important now that in the first minute of this next round.
Don't let him get that
and then let your shots go. Don't let him get back into this fight. Come on, you got this.
Big deep breath, bang him downstairs. Jab him downstairs, stop
back into the fight. Don't let him get that confidence. He's gonna be
the referee safe. Calling for seconds out as we get set to jump back in the action.
Get on top.
We're hoping for an all-action slugfest. So the fight will continue. How do they turn things around?
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to bluff it. They've got to bluff it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot. Jab. Rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then put the pressure.
Then land that jab. Crotch seeing cobwebs.
Beautiful sneaky shot to take his legs away from him.
To turn this around halfway through. So this was an unexpected turn of events. What happens next?
Somebody can smell blood here. They can smell blood. They've got to be smart. Get in there. Then boom, back in the same spot again. It happened once. You got away with it. You can do it again. He's up, but for how long? Look at him. On the heels. Look at him. There's nothing there. There's no defense. The eyes are glazed. It just takes one more clear shot. A clean one. And he's out of there.
Perfect counter lands. They exchange punches. You couldn't write a script like this. This is like Rocky versus Apollo. Final 10 seconds here, and I think he knows who's won this round. Talk about Crotch in that last round. Boy, this next round is going to be crucial considering the knockdown we just witnessed.
You're being put down. You've got to...
They ring the bell, and here we go. Got to get the momentum shift coming their way. What can they do here?
What a knockdown. 1 minute. You need 1 hour to get over a shot like that. Now it's down to conditioning. Now it's down to mental strength and preparation. It's how you are going to deal with it.
Can the Dark Destroyer get out of this dark place?
Bambi legs are kicking in. Look at those legs. The legs have gone.
Didn't wait long. And what else could they do but to take a knee here?
Best thing the fighter did. Otherwise, you know what? Pride's going to get you knocked out.
What do you think of this fight so far, Johnny? Wanted action, and they are giving us action. Halfway through the round, and I don't know who's got the advantage. Great stuff. Nobody home with that.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dares do anything out of turn.
Gotta let your hands go a little bit. It's okay to be aggressive there. Nice counter shot. Big hook thrown, but it doesn't connect. This is the kind of fight you expect from two world-class elite. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds. Oh, no. Nigel Penn in big trouble. And wisely, they're going to take a knee here. No choice but to do that.
What you're seeing right there is a heartbroken fighter.
Let's talk about Ben in that last round. The game plan does not seem to be working here. What's he have to do differently?
Wow, you know what? I've been in fights like that. When you're thinking, come on, Bell, ring away. You walk back to the corner like you've just seen the sun.
Look at him now.
Don't let him get back into this fight. Come on, you've got this. Don't.
It's so important now that in the first minute of this next round, you get on top of it.
Confidence. He's going to be stretching about his gas tank now. Keep whacking him to the body. Keep taking away that air. And every time you see him take a big, deep breath, bang him downstairs. Jab him downstairs.
Don't let him get back into the fight. Don't let him get that confidence. He's going to be spotted.
So important now in this first minute, this next round.
But taking away that air, every time you see him get a big, deep breath, bang him down.
Shots go. Don't let him get back into this fight. Come on, you've got this.
Don't let him get...
And there's the bell to start the round. Let's see how they bounce back here in this round.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on the end. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
Well, Johnny, has anything surprised you here as we enter the final frames of this battle?
Middleweight always gives us a class. If you've got two class middleweight fighters, you are in fight.
Nigel Benn has been rocked.
Oh, I heard that. Never by. Saw it.
Good job trying to back out of trouble.
Bean Days now needs to steady the pace. Get the pace back to normal.
Had a lot of punch output. Thought there might be more action here. This has been a very competitive round. So back into the fray again, but how much do they have left?
Some fighters, when this happens, this can be heartbreaking. Some fighters, it makes them angry. They want to get back into the mix again. I want to know, what sort of character are we looking at here?
Every time, total domination with 10 seconds to go. Talk about Ben in that last round. You've got to wonder how big of a factor that knockdown's going to be we just saw.
I love the response, though. Got back up, took a deep breath and thought, right, brush it off, get on with the job.
He's knackered, mate. He's knackered.
Just kick him behind the jab and then let his shots go. Don't let him get back in.
Confidence is going to be stretching out his gas tank. Keep whacking into the body.
Get back into the fight. Don't let him get that confidence. He's going to be stretching about his gas tank now. Keep whacking into the body. Take away that air. And every time you see him take a big, deep breath, bang him down.
To this fight, it's so important now that in the first minute of this next round,
don't let him get back into this fight. It's so important now.
And then let your shots go. Don't let him get back into this fight. Come on, you got this.
Working behind the jab and then let your shots go. Don't let him get back
into the fight. Don't let him get that confidence. He's gonna
Unfortunately, this fighter not going to get more time to heal up and get a breather right back into the action.
And get a big deep breath, bang him downstairs, jab him
downstairs. Jab just missed with the left hand. Well, Johnny, we're in the early stages here. What have you seen so far?
Sometimes when you have a fight, the best way to beat a fight is not give them what they want. Because they want to get you there. They want you to stand there toe-to-toe with them and have a tell. That's what they do in the gym every single day.
And he is gonna quit. Well, the corner has thrown in the towel, and that will do it. The fighter not happy, but those are the rules.
They don't like that. Listen to them. Oh, listen to that. When he gets back to the gym, his team is gonna give him hellfire. This is what you work on as a fighter.